Hey friends, in this video we're gonna host a simple Node.js Express REST API on AWS Lambda and then make it available with the application load balancer. This might be a good idea if you have a simple REST API and the traffic comes in bursts. With the console open, let's head over to Lambda. Let's create a new function. Let's use a blueprint, so a boilerplate. Let's use the hello world with Node.js 18. And let's call it my task API. So we're gonna allow this to create a new Lambda basic permissions to write to logs, etc. And here is the boilerplate. So let's get this created. Let's now test our Lambda. So we can go here into test and we can write here new event. And we can use these arguments here, that's fine. And we press the test button. It worked. Here's the outcome, value 1, and here are the logs. We can also go into CloudWatch, and that can be very useful if you need to troubleshoot. So here are the streams, and here we can see value 1, 2, and 3. Let's create an application load balancer to expose our API. So it's an EC2 feature, and we create a new load balancer, an application load balancer. We call it My Task API ALB. We have it internet facing, make it available in 3 zones. And then we want to create a new security group. My task API SG. And just the same description. And we're gonna add the rule for inbound traffic, HTTP. And we're gonna allow only my IP address. We're gonna create that. Then we're gonna go back here, refresh this list, and now we can select this new one. Then we're gonna create a new target group that allows the ALB to talk with the Lambda. So let's do that here. And we're gonna select here a Lambda function, my REST API target group, next. And we're gonna select a Lambda, and we're gonna select our Lambda and create. Alright, and then we can go back here, refresh the list, select our target group, and then we are done. We're gonna create the load balancer. So now we need to wait while it's provisioning. Let's head back into our Lambda and change it a bit. So we don't need this, and we want the HTTP response. So let's return an object, and let's have status code 200. Let's have headers, content type, text HTML, body, this is it, and then finally let's log the event, and then we deploy it. We now go back into a load balancer, let's see if it's ready. It is, alright, and let's try to access it here and see if this is working. Okay. Let's now change our Lambda a bit to see if it can work with query parameters. So here, instead of returning the body, let's return event.querystringParameters.id and let's deploy that. Then we go back here and we try to pass in id equals Jacob and it's working. And let's say we want to further evolve this and return JSON. Can go here and say application JSON, and then we want to return an object here, your ID, but that's not enough. We have to convert this into a string, so JSON.stringify. And let's deploy this and let's test it out. Awesome. We might want to continue to evolve this without a framework, but using something like Express just makes our lives much more easier. So let's do that. Here I have a simple Express REST API. Let's look at it. Let's look at the Express module. So here we have some tasks in memory and we can get the tasks. Get one task, create a task, update a task, and delete a task. And then this just exports then the Express app. Then we need a little bit of magic for our index file. So let's open that up. So we require here the app and serverless HTTP, and then we wrap the app with the serverless HTTP. Now let's zip our files. So we compress it here, we go back into our Lambda, and we say here upload from zip file. So we select the zip file, and we save it. Okay, it's here. So let's now try this again, but now with the parameter tasks to see if we can get all the tasks. It's working! Magic! Let's now test this out in the terminal. So I have some scripts here. So let's try to get everything here and use JQ to format it nicely. And then we can update task 1. Then we can add a few items. Then we can delete task 1. And then we can read everything again. So now task 1 has been deleted and we have new tasks here. Looking good. That's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. Please comment if you'd like me to take this forward. Thank you.